Hey, what is up, guys? So we have Cleese now back in the game. Apparently this was doing really well at some ARG, and it's using Cards of Demise with Cleese, and it apparently is a really good way to play control Cleese. So I got a bunch of replays that I'll share with you guys, and then we'll go ahead and go over a deck profile, because some people, maybe they jumped in the game when these weren't like the most meta of pendulum decks. This was the first, I would say, pendulum deck that anyone ever really played that was actually like competitive and viable in the game. It has been nerfed several times with the, you know, I guess, them taking away Scout, them also taking away Towers, because the deck has evolved, and like, Lose a Turn is probably one of the more stronger cards in Cleese, but nonetheless, you're going to see it in action against Cosmos as well as a Dark Magician deck. It's just really good. You guys will see Cards of Demise, and you'll see how good the card is. I mean, it's a pretty self-explanatory card, but the way that Cleese work is there's so many cards that basically make them unaffected by things. Like, for example, if you run Chalice, you can basically make your Cleese super strong. In addition to that, Chalice is just a good card. And there's so many other cards that you can run in the deck, like Rivalry of Warlords, like Lose a Turn, that are just so freaking good, and that can just instantly give you that win condition against certain decks. Now, you guys will see a few different duels, so you can see different scenarios. It's mostly against Cosmo, because I think that's kind of an important matchup anyways, because, you know, who ain't playing Cosmo after Shining Victories, right? The deck is just super, super strong, especially because, you know, moving forward with that new Cosmo card, Cosmourning, that's going to destroy certain things like Burning Abyss, things that revolve around the graveyard. That's going to destroy a lot of the meta, and it's kind of cool to see different things, you know, come back into the game. So, like I said, I got a few different replays to share with you guys with that. Thanks, Vape Nation, for sending in this replay. 10 out of 10 username, but anyways, Scout has still been one of, like, the more insane cards. The fact that you can search out Scout with Summoner's Art, and then Scout searches out other cards, and you can search Sacrifice, which searches out other cards anyways. So you can see he's able to flip that thing face down and tap over, but it doesn't really matter too much because he's going to get utility out of it anyways. And you see, like, he doesn't have to have the card every single turn, the Card of Demise, to actually be successful. Obviously, if you have that, that gives you a huge boost. Now he happens to have the Chalice over there, so he can negate his own effect, which is that he would only become 1800, so he can completely change that. But he's going to go ahead and actually activate that effect again. And then he's going to go ahead and bust out the ability to flip this face down. So that can kind of hurt. But the thing is, with Vandy's Emptiness and Cleese, and you'll see a duel where Cosmourning kind of actually hurts the player that is playing Cosmos. The reason why is because Vandy's Emptiness is such a strong card already. And because everything's going back to the extra deck, they never really get to go to the graveyard. Therefore, Vandy's Emptiness gets to stay on board. So that's a really huge advantage. And you can see now he's just filled up his extra deck with two cards, so he can go ahead and pendulum later on. Obviously, when Vandy's is gone, he activates Cosmojo, gets rid of the emptiness, because that is the problematic card that he has to deal with. But then, bam, he's going to get a bunch of monsters. Then a Solemn Strike happens, which I feel like in some pendulum decks, if they Solemn Strike you, that's game over. Now, if you already have your board established with Scout, you're just going to get three cards every turn anyway. So he goes ahead and busts out a Dark Destroyer. Vandy's emptiness was the other face down, but he had the MST to respond with it. And at this point, he's got full reign on what he wants to do. So he could have actually went for Shell. Shell actually does burn damage, so he's going to go ahead and reduce that attack. So he's got one, two monsters. Shell, I believe, it burns your opponent for each monster. Is it Shell? Or no, I'm sorry, it's not Shell. It's the Cephalopod. Cephalopod's the one that burns, I think, 300 for each one. And at this point, his opponent is just like, yo, you won, man. I didn't draw into it. Like, there's just too much control with this deck, and you guys will see some more control-ish type games, but it usually involves having the Cards of Demise. Like, if you have Cards of Demise plus like Magic Drains, like, you just destroy your opponent here. Like, he goes ahead and goes for the Stealth and then draws three. He has so many cards, he has to discard one. It's still plus though, because you're drawing three cards, but he goes ahead and activates MST, Magic Drain negating the MST, get negated MST. So he goes ahead and activates Cosmo Town, negates it with Magic Drain. Magic Drain is a very, very good card. A little bit older of a card, but it is pretty good. So I'm going to go over this, once we get into the deck profile, I guess we can go into like the full effect. Because sometimes, you know, these are older cards, people haven't seen them in so long. You either forget the effect or you know the card existed. But look at this, like, look how much free advantage this guy has generated against Cosmos. So again, Cosmos, one of the more meta decks right now, this format. And it's just showing you, like, how good this deck can be, because like they hit a lot of stuff and they're like, oh, Cosmo, we'll hit one Itali. Like, what? It didn't really hurt the deck, it didn't destroy the deck, or like really hurt it to the point where like people question playing it. Like, the deck is still very, very much alive. So here's the Cosmourning card. So then, like, anything that he would destroy from a Cosmo monster, it goes back into the deck, so it shuffles it back in. Usually that'd be pretty good against, again, like Burning Abyss, things that need the graveyard, right? But it can actually hurt you if the opponent has Vanny's Emptiness. So just keep that in mind sometimes if you are playing Cosmourning. Like, make sure they don't happen to have this up. But like, when your opponent's got Skill Drain, Lose a Turn, Vanny's Emptiness, and they're playing Cleese, like, it's a very, very hard battle for most decks to even, you know, combat with at all, because it's just too much of an advantage that your opponent has, because it's just like, Lose a Turn, so anytime you special summon something, it's just gonna get its effect, and you have Skill Drain that you have to deal with, like, and then you have Emptiness, so it's like, good luck trying to even get out anything in the first place. But even if you do, it's going to either go to the defense mode, or, I mean, he's still got Chalice down here, and he's got a Magic Ring, so he's got this card. Skill Drain is one of the better cards in play, just because it's like, you know what, all the monsters that is Pendulum are gonna have a full attack. In addition to that, it doesn't really hurt the deck too much, because a lot of them get their effects when they are tributed. Anyways, so from there, you'll be good to go. This next one up here is just going to be really quick versus a Dark Magician deck. But again, it's just trying to show you guys the power that this deck still technically has in the game, because it's been nerfed multiple times. Also, Wavering Eyes, that card took a hit. So, yeah, I mean, that was a great card too. And Surf Scout, man. So Lose a Turn is activated, and he's going to go ahead. He draws Mahad and actually is able to special summon it. But he activates the Dark Magic Circle, he goes ahead and Magic Drains that, and Magic Drain, its effect is, when your opponent activates a spell card, they can discard one spell card to negate this card's effect, otherwise negate the activation of their spell card, and if you do, destroy it. So he could have gotten rid of it. I think that would have been an okay plan, just because Regeki isn't the greatest against Cleese, especially in a deck where you can't OTK, and his hand did not have an OTK type of hand, so I think that would have been an option. So he goes ahead and keeps Dark Magic Circle. But, yeah, you really need that effect where you can, you know, activate it and look at the top three cards. I believe he negated the other card and he discarded it, so I don't know, missed timing or whatever on that. But maybe it was too fast, I couldn't see it. But nonetheless, he goes ahead and summons Choco Magician Girl, but that is going to be negated by the Solemn Strike. And then, obviously, there it is, game. Now, here's going to be, like a perfect, like, destroyed you turn one lockdown. This is what you can do in this deck, so go for Summoner's Art, search out the Scout. I would have searched off of Scout first, and then completed my scale or whatever, and then went for Cards of Demise. I thought that would have been a play also. But nonetheless, Rivalry of Warlords, this is a really great card in Cleese. So it's each player summons monsters they control the graveyard, so they only control one type of each monster. Each player can only control one type of monster. Even if you're getting rid of the monster tributing, it has to be the same one. That's how it's ruled. So this can destroy like certain other decks. For example, like Monarchs, or like, there's a lot of different things where this can just like absolutely destroy things, because they have to control the same type of monster. And you can see over here, he's got Lose a Turn, he's got Skill Drain, and Rivalry, and like he's got a Chalice, and there's just really no coming back from this. And again, Cosmos, they're really popular right now, so this can maybe be a good deck if you want to maybe combat them. But anyways, I know a lot of you guys want the deck profile file for this deck, because maybe you had Cleese lying around. I still have my Cleese deck lying around, so this could be something you guys want to try out. It has apparently one and ARG, so this is a good little deck, and I'd say it's relatively budget friendly. I mean, obviously the extra deck wasn't even really used, but I would still think it's better to have an extra deck and not use it. I mean, obviously Solemn Strike can be expensive, but you can replace this with maybe like a Bottomless or something like that, or something maybe that just hits multiple things. But for the most part, it is a very control-based deck. This is not a summon bunch of monsters, OTK your opponent. It's a slower deck, but you can see it can be successful against a deck that is very fast like Cosmos. But let's go into right into the deck profile. So, we got triple copies of Stealth, we got two copies of Disc, one Carrier, one Helix, one Shell, one Monolith, and one Scout. I know you're like, oh, there's three copies of Summoner Art. The thing is, guys, sometimes your cards will go back. I mean, it's not that often, but the thing is, this deck relies on having control immediately, so you need that turn one scout. It's still pretty good, even though you only have two targets to run three of them. Again, it's consistency issues. Sometimes you don't even really need to use all of them to be successful, and if you've already had scout, you're probably going off anyways. Next up, we have three copies of Cards of Demise, three copies of Summoner's Art, 3 Duality, 2 Chalice, 2 Mystical Space Typhoons, 1 Sacrifice, 1 Raigeki, 3 Triple Magic Drains, get rid of them Pendulums. Then we have 3 copies of Loser's Parent, 3 copies of Solemn Strike, 2 copies of Rivalry, 1 copy of Starlight, 1 Warning, 1 Skill Drain, 1 Vandy's Emptiness. For the extra deck, he's playing 1 Cyber End Dragon, 1 Stardust, 1 Gaia, 2 copies of Cyber Dragon Infinity, 1 Nova, 1 Zenmayo, Pleiades, Volcasaurus, Durendal, S39 Utopia Lightning, and then we have S39 Utopia Prime, of course the OG Utopia, Castell, and Ragnzero. Excellent card in Cleese because the Cleese have the effect that, all three monsters you control in the game. There's one that, here it is. So some of them, all of the Cleese monsters lose 300 attack. You can technically make this with the Perform Pal Trump Cat, Trampolinix. That is the card that you can actually use. And you can actually bounce back the Cleese stuff, and then you can spell summon, and then that can allow you to go for like other things. And then on top of that, you can place the Klee cards on afterwards, and then you can have your extra deck stuff. It just makes it much easier. If you guys want to try out this card, you guys can go ahead and try it out. But for the most part, this is very control-based, so if anything, maybe you don't have Solemn Strike, so you want to make it a little bit more budget-friendly. You have zero of these. Throw in this, throw in Bottomless, and then pick some surprise card for yourself. But as far as his side deck, I don't know if this was actually the ARG's like side deck, but I know that this deck... from what I know, it has topped in the ARG, so it is slightly competitive. So we got 3 Master Restrict, 3 Shadow Imprisoning Mirror, 3 Iron Wall, 2 Monarch Stormforth, the 3rd Mystical, and a Triple Maxi. So looking like a pretty fun deck. Let me know, guys, if you would change anything about this deck. But overall, I think it's a pretty decent deck. Kind of cool to see something kind of return back into the game that was super strong. And just going back to a slower game format, even though this is kind of annoying to play against because it is so control heavy based. Like you can't, like your opponent can't Yu-Gi-Oh at all. And that is the goal of the deck though. I mean, it's not like an OTK crazy deck. It's nice once in a while to run into something that just does not OTK, but although it does not let you Yu-Gi-Oh, so it is kind of unfortunate also to run into, but nonetheless, it's a fun little deck. Have some fun with it, guys. Let me know your thoughts on it. But anyways, thanks Vape Nation for sending in this deck profile. Make sure you guys give that like button a titty slap, and thanks for watching, guys. I'm signing out.